Hello, my dear students. Today's topic is forestry. Forestry is the science and craft of creating, managing, using, conserving and repairing forest, woodlands and associated resources for human and environmental benefits, that is forestry. What is a forestry? It is a science and craft of creating, managing, using, conserving and repairing forest, woodlands and associated resources for human and environmental benefits, that is the forestry. There are several kinds of forestry: social forestry, agroforestry, etc. First, we will see about the agroforestry. It is an integration of trees, crops, and livestock on the same plot of land. The main objectives in the agroforestry is on the interaction among them. For example, intercropping. Intercropping means mixed cropping. Intercropping of two or more crops between different species of trees and shrubs. In between one type of species, different type of species will be cultivated. That is mixed cropping. It results in higher yielding and reducing the operation costs. This combination of agriculture and forestry has varied benefits, including increased biodiversity and reduced erosion. Some of the major species cultivated in commercial agroforestry includes casuarina, number one, number two, eucalyptus, number three, Malay bamboo, number four, teak plant, number five, kadambu trees, etc., which are identified as commercial timber among the 20 species of trees. They are very important to wood-based industries. Right, you will see the benefits of agroforestry. It improves soil conservation and water conservation. It reduces landslide and water runoff problems. The trees provided microclimate for crops and maintain oxygen and carbon dioxide balance, atmospheric temperature and relative humidity. The trees which are used in the agroforestry provide microclimate for crops and maintain oxygen carbon dioxide balance, atmospheric temperature and relative humidity, etc. It is also suitable for dry land cultivation where rainfall is minimum. So it is a good system for alternate land use pattern. Trees like acacia, multi-purpose trees used for wood pulp, tanning, paper and firewood industries, can be used as a form forestry for the extension of forest, mixed forestry, shelter belts and a linear stripe plantation. Mixed forestry means forest with different kinds of trees are grown. Coniferous forest, deciduous forest, like that. The trees are selected from different forest and are used for the agroforestry, etc. Shelter belts. Shelter belts are stripes of vegetation composed of trees and shrubs grown along the coastal area to protect coastal areas from high velocity wind and also tsunami. They also act as sand binders and prevent sand erosion. What is linear stripe vegetation? Plantation of different kinds of plants, that is first growing species of plants growing on linear stripes of land, that is the linear stripe plantation. Now we'll pass on to the rehabilitation of degraded forest and recreation forest. When the forest is damaged, when the forest is totally unfit, and those forests will be rehabilitated, and that will be bring to the right path, in the right path. The production of woody plants combined with pasture is referred as silvopasture system. In this system, trees and shrubs are used primarily to produce fodder for livestock, or they are grown for timber, fuel, wood and fruits. Plants are also used to improve the soil. Now come to the classification. The silvopasture system is classified into two types. One is protein bank and another one is leaf fence. What is a protein bank? Multipurpose trees are planted in and around the land for fodder production, that is the protein bank. When the multipurpose trees are planted in and around the land for fodder production, that is called protein bank. For example, Acacia nilotia, Albasia labac, Azadirachta indica, Glyricidia sepium, Sesvania grandiflora, these are all the plants which are used for protein bank. Protein bank means the plants which contain enormous amount of protein, the plants which store protein content maximum, that is called protein bank plants. Leaf fence. Various fodder trees and hedges are planted as leaf fence to protect the property from stray animals or other biotic influences. Hedges is a line of closely spaced shrubs and sometimes trees planted in the form of a linear or to mark the boundary between the neighboring property, that is hedges. Example, Clericidia sepium, Sesvania grandifloria, Erythrina species and Acacia species are used as leaf fence. So today now we have seen about the agroforestry in general. Then benefits of agroforestry, rehabilitation of degraded forest and recreation of the forest, classification we have seen. Now we have to see about the social forestry. Social forestry refers to the sustainable management of forests by local communities for carbon sequestration, change mitigation. Mitigation means to reduce the severity for anything, maybe pollution or anything. Depollution, deforestation, forest restoration, providing indirect employment opportunity for the youth. So that is the social forestry. Social forestry refers to the management of forest and afforestation in barren lands to the development and benefits of environment, social and rural. Forest program is done for the benefits of the people and participation of the people. The social forestry, in social forestry, trees grown outside the forest by the government and public organization that reduce pressure on forest. In order to encourage the tree cultivation outside the forest, tree cultivation in private lands was implemented in the state from 2007, 2008 to 2011 and 2012. It was implemented by carrying out block planting. What is block planting? Vegetables are, when the vegetables are planted in blocks, that is block planting. When the plants are planted in separate areas, space, block or rows, rather than the traditional system, that is the block planting. And intercrop planting, already we have seen the intercrop planting. In between the main crops, some of the shrubs, herbs are cultivated, that is mixed cropping or intercropping or interplanting or mixed planting, etc. With profitable tree species for planting in the lands, in private lands, and creating awareness among students by giving training and camps. The Tang foreshore plantation. Tang foreshore plantation means the ground between the water's edge and cultivated land, or land along the edge of the water body, that is called Tang foreshore. The part of the shore between the high water tank, water mark, and low water mark. The Tang foreshore plantation have been a major source of firewood in Tamil Nadu. There are 32 forestry extension centers which provide technical support for the growing in rural areas in Tamil Nadu. These centers provide quality trees, seedlings, saplings like thorn, thornless bamboo, casuarinas, teak, neem tree, Malia dubia, grafted tamarind and nelly tree. These are all the things supplied by the centers. Major activities of the forest extension center, we see that training given for the tree growing methods. Here in the forestry extension centers, these are all the activities given. Training given for tree growing methods, number one. Number two, publicity and propaganda regarding tree growing are carried out. Number third, formation of demonstration class. They are separate class are allotted in order to demonstration for the growing forest trees in this method. Raising and supply of seedlings on subsidy basis, the seedlings, tree seedlings will be supplied. Awareness creation among school children and youth about the importance of forest through training and camps, etc. So these are all the major activities of the forest extension centers. So that's all about the social forestry.